party trick. You can hold your glass the way that I'm holding mine, where I take my ring and my pinky finger, pop it on the bottom of your glass, and then wrap your other three around the stem. It just helps you support your glass a little bit more. And then all it takes is a nice flick of the wrist, and you get a really good tornado going in there.
So once you swirl it, give your wine a good smell. I just kind of shove my nose right in the glass.
Now, to a lot of people that are new to the wine smelling world, they kind of always go, smells like wine. If that's all you can pick up on right now, that is totally fine. Good job you, because if it smelled like anything other than wine, I'd be concerned. But basically, when you smell wine, sometimes you can actually pick up on individual food aromas. So for me, when I smell our Riesling, I smell green apple. To me, it's the smell you get when you freshly bite into a Granny Smith apple. It's that little bit sweet and little bit tart. Other people can pick up on aromas of pear, peach, and lemon in our Riesling as well. Now, the first sip you have of any wine is going to cleanse your palate. It gets rid of any coffee, toothpaste, lunch, whatever you had going on before. And your second sip is where you actually taste the wine itself. Now, I've met a lot of people in my time that take a single sip of a, like, wine and go, ew, I don't like that. Don't be that person. Never, ever judge a wine by its first sip. Give it a second try, and then you can judge it a little bit. So cheers, folks, and enjoy your Riesling. Months ago. So we like to humble brag a little bit that we are the best winery in Canada, and we even have a trophy to prove it, so go us. I can take no credit for any of this. I've only been here for 7 months, but that's okay. Now, at that same competition, our Cabernet Merlot here also picked up an award, which is why it gets a fancy little sticker, and it got the award for best value red wine, meaning it's a very good quality for a very reasonable price. It's only $14.75. I don't know about you folks, but like $15 and under is where I like to keep the price point of my wines, because student debt problems. So the fact that you can get an international award-winning wine for under $15 is actually pretty spectacular. So Okian award-winning is option one. Now option two is our Cabernet Gamay. Now throughout the summer, this was one of my personal favorite red wines. And the reason why I loved it so much is because it's a little bit lighter and a little bit sweeter. This wine's aged entirely in stainless steel, so instead of that heavy oakiness, it's really nice and light and fresh and fruit forward. So I call this the perfect hot summer's day, easy drinking kind of red, or if you're me, this is the PJs on your couch watching Netflix. So sweeter and good with Netflix is option number two. You gotta be brutally honest at these wine tastings. Now as well, we are drinking our wines in the correct order today, so there is no need to rinse out your glass in between each tasting, because the flavor of the previous wine is never going to influence the flavor of your next wine. So whenever you guys are ready, you can come on up and let me know which of the two reds you'd prefer to try. So come on down. This is going to be our 2016 Vidal Ice Wine. Now, who here has never tried an ice wine before? Yes, I love people that are new to ice wine. Okay, so... It's because I love this stuff. It's terrible how much I love it, because my doctor won't approve. But ice wine, for those that may or may not know, is a super sweet dessert wine. To give you an idea just how sweet this wine is, the Riesling you all had first had about 17 grams of sugar per liter in it. This bad boy has 220 grams of sugar per liter in it. So it's just a little bit sweeter than what you're probably used to. Now, when you drink an ice wine, there is actually a proper way to drink it. And the trick is to not let it touch the tip of your tongue. Because the tip of your tongue is where you're the most sensitive to sweet things. So if you try to drink ice wine back with a regular glass of wine, all you end up tasting is that sugar. But if you drink it properly and you tuck the tip of your tongue behind your bottom front teeth, like, yeah, it's cute, I know. And then push the wine to the back of your tongue, that's where you pick up on the complex fruit flavors and less of the sugar. So in the case of our ice wine, you get lots of apricot and peach and honey and all things good and delicious. Now, ice wine is also one of those things that you don't really find everywhere in the world. Here in Ontario, we are the world's leading producer of ice wine. And the simple reason why we make a lot of it is because we're one of the few places that it actually gets cold enough to make it. So these grapes have to be left on the vine to freeze naturally during the winter. So this is our Vidal ice wine. It's made from the Vidal grape. Now, the temperatures have to drop to between -8 and -20 degrees Celsius, or about 17 to -4 Fahrenheit, also known as really freaking cold. Now, what ends up happening is these grapes are normally made of about 70% water. So all that water inside the grape actually turns to ice.
and all you're left with is the super sweet, super concentrated nectar inside. So these grapes are one of the only ones to be picked by hand. Don't let this fool you. This was one year that we had to pick everything really quickly because the temperatures were going up, so we had to machine harvest. But most years we pick them by hand, so that means it has to be done in the middle of the night on one of the coldest nights of the year. The reason why? These grapes cannot thaw. They have to be pressed at the same temperature at which they were picked, and if they melt at all, they legally cannot be considered ice wine grapes here in Ontario. There's very, very strict regulations on it. Now, when you press these grapes while they're frozen, you only get a single drop of juice per grape, and that's it. So in order to make a bottle this size, which is the biggest you'll find of any ice wine, by the way, it's 375 milliliters, this would have taken about 4,000 grapes to make. That's almost 100 times more than the number of grapes needed to make a regular size bottle of wine during the normal harvest. So that's why you'll always notice ice wine bottles are teeny tiny and very expensive. So whenever you guys are ready, you can come on down for some ice wine. Don't worry about that tiny drop of red in the bottom of your glass, because this baby's gonna cancel all flavor of that.